I arrived on campus in 1982 for an interview. And when I saw this campus, I thought, where am I? Venice, Italy? It just looked like a place that doesn't belong in Roseville, Minnesota. Over the 32 years that I taught here, I taught principles of art, art history, and some of those art history classes included sacred architecture and a study of Charles J. Connick's stained glass windows. Built in 1925, the small Gothic chapel includes the work of Charles J. Connick, the greatest American stained glass maker of the 20th century. The chapel seems to have gone out of use sometime before Northwestern took over the property. The windows had been vandalized. The sculpture, the altarpiece, the altar had been removed and taken into the possession of the archdiocese. So the chapel just got closed. My dad, who worked as an auto shop employee at Northwestern College, he said, have you ever seen that chapel? I said, no, I've never been in there. Just a rundown chapel. Well, we got the key and he opened it up. I just walked into that chapel and the reds and blues just came alive. Where the window used to be were just fragments. And I always wondered what that window looked like and what it would look like to have that window back. My dad loved that chapel. So when my father passed away, we used some of the memorial gifts to think about restoring that window. And then we met David Cummings, and J.T. Glass. And together we put together a plan to restore that window.
When Mark Baden first brought the remnants of this window, it had been vandalized. Most of it was missing. So it was, I think, first of all, a challenge, but also an opportunity to be able to work with, in a sense, a great artist, stained glass artist like Charles Connick. I've been working in the stained glass area for almost 40 years. I've worked on many of the windows for the Minneapolis Institute of Arts. I've done their conservation restoration work for a number of years. Mark Baden brought to the studio here the less than 5% of the original window remaining. We had just enough to extrapolate the whole of the window. Fortunately, we did have some copies of the original artwork, which were obviously indispensable in recreating this window. We took templates of the opening and recreated a drawing of the full-size window. It's quite an honor to be able to recreate the Charles Connick window. He is one of the most highly regarded stained glass artists of the last 100 years or so.
I've come to a place where I think I know more about Charles Connick than most people. It's fascinating. What David said was it's the most complex window he's ever made. I believe that. Every once in a while, I would think we were doing the impossible. And then the next day, we'd make a little more progress.
J.T. Palmer is currently a production stained glass studio, specializing in restoration, repair, and new work. It is a studio that is very knowledgeable, concerned about the work that it does. It's an important part of this stained glass industry to keep and maintain historical artifacts, historical windows.
Northwestern was awarded a campus preservation planning grant from the Getty Center in Los Angeles, California. And really that grant kicked off a renewed effort to understand and restore, whenever possible, the original campus. And it's been such a privilege for us to have the beauty that existed long before we got here. The Island Chapel is one of those places that needs a little bit of work.
Building the first window for this space has been a very satisfying project, and I'm really pleased to know that we're going to be continuing. There will be 6 more conic windows that we will recreate. The building is going to be needing a lot more restoration, but we have a good feel for the stained glass part of it.
Stained glass was originally created in the Middle Ages to illustrate the scriptures. And so a medieval stained glass window is really a theological statement of the truths found in scripture. The rose window represents that great theological truth of God in 3 persons, the 3 doves flying toward the center, surrounded by 3 crowns of thorns. Around the entire composition are 9 roses, which represent the 9 choirs of angels. It's a beautiful symbol. The whole process of saying, I have a 3-inch circular painting, can I make that into a 24-inch window? What's an adventure? But the result has been incredible, thanks to Gaty Palmer and David Cummings.